triangle from Butterfly Guard, and a few more options from here as well. So, first thing from here, I'm going to be looking for is his head control. I'm grabbing like so, and clamping my elbow down nice and tight if I can. What I do with the arm and with my other hand sort of depends on what he does. I can grab the wrist, I can grab the tricep, I can overhook deep for one. Okay, as any will do, I usually grab the tricep. And you know, this is good as well. So what I'm going to do from here is I'm going to put this from the hip, right here. Keep my bum back, and what I'm looking for is for him to not do much with this arm. Okay, as I'm looking to make him forget head up, make him forget about that arm. All I'm distracting, I'm going to push him, pull him for the arm and the head, and I'm going to start kicking at this leg and take his balance away. And come back up. So, and what he's done is his leg has made a mistake of putting his hand on the floor. And from there, I'm going to slide over to the triangle. Even if he does not put his hand on the floor, which you can still do this. I'm here. Another grip I can take is like so. Do you just want to look? Like a reverse of an arm drag. Or I can be here. So, tricep, head control at the very least. This is on the hip. Head posture up. And I'm going to kick him with this foot, this knee, sorry. And what we've done there is, he puts his hand on the floor, and that moment I'm going to come over, and I've got the triangle. Head, arm, this foot on the hip. I'm going to kick his knee, trying to push it out as much as possible, very quickly. He's going to have to put his hand and his elbow down. When he does, triangle. Either straight here into the finished triangle, or here, trying to get the arm across a little more. Two. So, if for whatever reason this is not working, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take this hand at the back of the head. I'm going to use it to guide his head down to my upper armpit to get the guillotine. From here, coming the triangle, like so, that's the guillotine. And keep my arm out, like so. Should be possible to use the guillotine from there. If his leg's stuck, you're going to push that into his thigh, push hips forward and curl down in his leg. Put his head down, and if he makes the mistake of, as a lot of people do, using this hand to push down on my wrist to try and break that triangle grip, that guillotine grip, sorry, well, and I can't finish the guillotine, well, he's put his hand on my wrist, so I'm going to push my wrist down, and I'm going to come back into the triangle. And I can do this one without the foot on the hip, just from a normal butterfly guard. Do it with just the head control. I'd like to work from here. Doesn't matter if you have the arm over, the arm under. I can finish the guillotine from here. If you start attacking my wrist, then push that down. I've got the triangle. The reason when I'm setting up this triangle, so I'm putting the foot on the hip, is if this doesn't work, the triangle doesn't work, I've also got the option of a very good sweep. So I'll do the other side. I'm grabbing the head, grabbing the arm, the same side as I'm grabbing the arm, that leg, grabbing the hip, and I've still got my underhook and this leg. I'm going to fall onto my right shoulder. Sideways, I'm not going back at all.
hip, head up. I'm going to lift my left leg. Straight over. Take the front, put the arm on the hip. All I'm going to do is go sideways and really push this in. And look with my right foot and then lift my left foot. You see, because of that push to the hip, he's getting swept in midair. He's already in position before he even touches the floor. I'm not going back at all. If I go back, he's just going to flatten me out. I'm going sideways onto my shoulder and my tricep. Like so. Come back down. Not giving me that hand, not getting it close to the floor, he knows what he's doing. Good team. Starts defending. Step down. Go for the triangle. And then, none of this is working. Corner of the triangle, I can't get a bit of feet. So I'm going to go to the side. And then sweep, pushing up into his hip. Quite a few options there. So, we're working off this guard pass. This guard pass comes up quite a lot as a side foot and coming back. What we'll do is, and this comes up from a butterfly guard, he'll come under here, climb that inside, he'll hide his head there, and he'll come around underneath and grab either my shin or my foot on this side. Just grab the shin. Yeah. It can be quite tricky. You're gonna walk around and pass here. Yeah. So what I'm gonna do is he's pushing his head that way. He's trying to hide his head from punches. And if I manage to push his head this way, I'm going to be able to get space and get my guard back and possibly get a triangle. So he's going to hide his head there. Okay, so from here, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to push his head a bit more and I'm going to bring his leg over to the other side. Like this. And I'll push this leg all the way through. From there, I'm going to look up. I've got the inverted triangle. It's very tight. You squeeze, and you're still not finishing him. I try and grab it here. I'm going to pull this in. Get it tighter. Very tight. So, this is the guard pass that comes up a lot. This is my favourite guard pass. It comes up a lot. So I've got an MMA as well. So I'm going to push the way he wants his head. This comes over. This leg comes under. And I lock up my leg. I can grab my finger to help myself lock it up a bit more. I squeeze. Look at that. It's not something to be expecting because
He wants this shin, his leg, to go that way. He wants to hop over. He wants to push it that way. I'm not going to finish from here. Grab my shin, lock it up. I've got it there. Okay? It's got the guard pass. I don't know the name for this. I just call it the chin trap guard pass. So I'm going to push here. As he's coming around me, you can do this at the same time. You're going to make sure this is over. Push this leg through. Keep this tight. Grab. Close. And squeeze. Again, if you want, you can reach. Grab here. Put it towards you to help. Okay? That is the inverted triangle.